the same integer is your answer, that is the identity. Okay, here multiply, so multiplicative identity. But you take the minus 3, but your answer is 3. So it is contradiction, so it is not a multiplicative identity of integers. But this one, what do we say this one? First you take the minus 3, but the answer is plus 3. So this is the additive inverse. Okay, additive inverse means what? You take a negative integer, you get the answer is positive integer. You take the positive integers, you get the negative integers, that is the additive identity we have already learned. Okay, okay, note, 0 is the additive identity for integers. Okay, any integer added with 0, the same value is your answer. So 0 is the additive identity for integers. Okay, in multiplicative identity is 1 is the multiplicative identity for integers. Minus 83 is the integer, multiply 1, the same minus 83 is your answer. So in the multiplication, 1 is the multiplicative identity for integers. But now minus 1 is not a multiplicative identity. Okay, we say this one for additive identity. Minus 3, minus 3, the additive inverse of minus 3 is plus 3. Additive inverse of 29 is minus 29. So the third one is, when we multiply minus 1 to a means variable, that means any number, okay, any integer, we get additive inverse of an integer a means that additive inverse of that number. Okay, that is a into minus 1 equal to minus 1 into a equal to, that's the, your answer is minus a. That means take a positive integer to be multiplied by minus 1, you get the negative integer. Okay, it is the, it is not a multiplicative identity, it is, we say that additive inverse of the integer. Okay, associativity of our multiplication. Okay, this is the general form of associative property. In general, for any three integers a, b and c, okay, here the three variables used to be used here, okay, a into b, it is grouped together, okay, it is grouped together, a into b into c equal to, this is the left hand side, equal to a into b and c is grouped together. Okay, this is the general form of integers for associative property for multiplication. Okay, example, consider, let us take three integers, minus 3, minus 2 and 5. Here the value of a equal to minus 3, value of b equal to minus 2 and value of c equal to 5. 5 means positive, okay, positive 5. But put the value in left hand side, a into b into c, okay, minus 3, value of a is minus 3 into value of b equal to minus 2, group together into c, value is 5. First you calculate this one, these two integers are negative integers. First you multiply the number, okay, 3 2s are 6, minus into minus plus, so just we write 6, the third one is multiply 5, so 6 5s are 30, okay, the left hand side over, the move to the right hand side, put the value in a into b into c, okay, value of a equal to minus 3 into b into c, value of b equal to minus 2 into c, value is 5. This one is grouped together. First you calculate this one. Okay. Here minus 2 is a negative integer, 5 is a positive integer to be multiplied. So first you multiply the number, 2 5s are 10. Here minus, multiply, here positive. So minus into plus minus. Okay. Minus into plus. 5 is a positive. So put the positive sign. So minus into plus minus. The first one is minus 3. So multiply these calculations, we get the answer is minus 10. The two integers are negative integers, minus 3 and minus 10. First you multiply the number, 3 tens are 30, minus into minus plus. So just write 30. So in your left hand side answer is 30, right hand side answer also 30. So is the two things, LHS equal to RHS. So it is satisfied for associative property. Okay. In this case, here multiplication, okay, associativity for multiplication. So LHS, this one value and this the right hand side value both are equal. So this is called the associative property for multiplication of integers. Okay, children. Today's homework, learn the properties of multiplication of integers. First one, closure property. Second one, commutative property. And multiplication by zero, multiplicative identity. And the last one, associativity for multiplication. So learn the properties thoroughly. Thank you.